Good morning, class. Welcome to our online math tutorials. I am teacher April Rose Hinerato Hachero. For today's video, our lesson is about solving linear in one variable. Review expressions, equations, inequalities. Okay, class, what is mathematical expression? Yung expression na sinasabi, no? Mathematical expression consists of constants, variables, or a combination of both and arithmetic operations. So, yan yung tinatawag na expressions, no? For example, we have x squared plus 2x plus 1, no? Yan, no? This is an example of an expressions or sabi niya, dapat daw, no, pwede man sa may constant. So, 100 is a constant. Or, sabi niya, merong combination ng constant and a variable. Ito, negative 7x. So, this is also called an expression. Alright, tandaan. Next, a mathematical statement composed of two expressions set equal to one another. Sabihin, ito yung symbol ng equal sign, di ba? Sabi niya, dapat daw, no, ang mathematical statement, no, this example, 28 is equals to 4k plus 7. Ibig sabihin, yung 28 na do, yung nasa left side mo, dapat yung 4k plus 7, yung value ng k na to, no, kapag itatimes mo sa 4 at i-add mo sa 7, dapat ang answer nito ay 28 kasi sabi niya equal. Dapat yung dalawang expression na to ay magparehas, no? Mag-equal set, no? Yan yung sinasabi niya. For example, 3 is equals to g. Ibig sabihin yung g ng value na to ay 3, no? So, if you substitute mo yung value ng g, 3, magiging equal na yung 3 is equals to 3. Yan, ganun siya, no? Yan yung sinasabi na evaluation. So, kailangan mong i-evaluate, no, para makuha mo yung value ng missing, no, missing variable. Parang ganon. So, this is an also an example of a mathematical statement, no, y plus 5 is equals to 1. No, we are looking for the value of y na ganon, no, equation. Tandaan. Sinabi namang inequality, ibig sabihin, no, not equal, no, pwede kang gumamit ng symbol na not equal, greater than, less than, greater than equal, or less than equal. Ito, kapag itong nakita mo na mga symbol niya, ibig sabihin, no, that is an mathematical statement, no, that shows one algebraic expression is not equal to the other algebraic expression. No, kanina equal siya, ito naman ay not equal. No, yan yung tinatawag na inequality. Kapag makita mo yung mga inequality signs, so that is an example of inequality. Alright? 4z, no, less than equal to 8 plus z. Yan, that is an example of inequality. 10, less than 3d. So, hindi ito magiging, yung 3d na to, kung imumultiply mo yung value ng d sa 3, no, mas malaki pa itong value niya kaysa sa 10. Ganun yung sinasabi ng inequality, no? Hindi talaga siya magiging equal. Tandaan nyo yan, alright? Solving linear equations in one variable. Class, so before we solve, no, we need to remember this first, no? A linear equation in one variable is an equation which can be written in the form ax plus b is equals to c. Tandaan nyo yung a, b, kag c. Yan yung mga real numbers. No? Real numbers, it means mga whole number or the real numbers. Pero dapat kuno yung a, yung value ng a na to ay not equal to 0. Tandaan nyo yun ha. Para yan sa linear equation, dapat daw yung value ng a is not equal to 0. Okay, let's have an example. Linear equation in one variable, no? Ganito yung example niya. Sample is 2x plus 3 is equals to 11. Therefore, yung a natin dito ay 2, yung b mo is 3, and yung 11, that is c. No? Yan yung real numbers natin. Yan, ganyan yung pagsulat nun. No? With one variable, ibig sabihin yung variable natin, ito x. No? X yung variable dito. No, one variable lang. Ito naman, pwede din siyang isulat na ganito. 2 quantity x minus 1 close quantity equals 8. Or can be written, no, ito ginawa yan, dinistribute yun na 2 times x kaya nag 2x. plus, no, 2 times negative 1, negative 2 is equals to 8 niyan. Pwede din ganito ang pagsulat niya, no? That is also an expression, example of linear equation. 8x is equals to 12, no? Same lang yan. Ito naman, no, take down note, no, not linear equation in one variable. Bakit? Kasi nga, ito, example, 2x plus 3y equals 11, no? This is a linear equation but not in one variable because we have given two variables here, no? The x and y. So, this is not one variable. Yes, this is a linear equation but not in one variable. Tandaan. Ito naman, example, quantity x minus 1 quantity squared is equals to 8. So, this is not one variable, no? This is example of a linear equation but not a, this is not a linear equation, I mean. But this is a one variable, hindi siya linear equation because of the squared, no? Pag sinabing squared na yan, iba na yung quadratic na yan, ha? So, hindi pa yan yung lesson natin. So, tandaan nyo lang, dapat yung x daw is x only, no? Wala siyang exponent na 2, 3, 4. 1 lang na yung exponent ng x para masabi mong linear. Ha? Tandaan. Now, this is also not a linear equation in one variable because, no, we have a denominator of x, no? Variable in the denominator. So, 3, so yun, tingnan mo, naka-denominator yung x mo. So, this is not an linear equation in one variable. Alright? Any value of the variable x that makes the equation true is called a root or a solution set to the equation. No, ibig sabihin, kung ano daw yung makuha mong value ng x na to, dapat daw ay equal siya sa left and right side. Kung yan ay mag-equal, that is your solution. No? For example, is 3 is a solution of 2x plus 3 equals 11? So, tinatanong niya, if yung 3 daw ba is a solution, no? Yung to this expression ay dapat daw ba magiging 11 ito? Yung 2x plus 3 is equals to 11. Parang ganun yung sinasabi niya, no? So, let's solve. 2x plus 3 is equals 11. So, this is your equation, original equation, di ba? So, sabi niya, isubstitute mo yung value ng x sa 3. So, 2 times 3, which is the value of x, no? 2x, 2 times 3 plus 3 equals 11. 2 times 3 is 6 plus 3 is 9 is not equal to 11. So, therefore, yung 3 na to is not the solution, no? False equation. Hindi yan yung solution sa 2x plus 3 equals 11. Alright? Let's have an example. Is 4 a solution of 2x plus 3 equals 11? So, tingnan natin kapag daw ba yung 4 i-substitute mo dito sa x na yan, magiging 11 ba yan? So, let's have an example. 2x plus 3 equals 11. Ito yung original equation. Isulat mo yon. Then, i-replace mo yung value ng x sa 4 kasi sabi niya is 4. No? Is the solution 2 times 4, that is 8, plus 3 equals 11. So, 8 plus 3 is, alright, so that is a 11 equals 11. Therefore, nagtama na siya, no? Check. So, this is a true equation. Therefore, 4 is a solution of 2x plus 3 equals 11. Reflexive property of equality. Any value or number is equal to itself. So, example, x is equals to x. That is called a reflexive property. Or 4 is equals to 4. Ibig sabihin, equal yung left and right side. Ang tawag dun ay reflexive property of equality. Next, symmetric property of equality. Ibig sabihin, no, if x is equals to y, then y is equals to x. Symmetric, for the word symmetric o symmetry, magkamukha, parehas lang din, no? If x is equals to 10, then 10 is equals to x, no? No, if x is y, if your value of y is 10, then 10 is equals to x, no? Y is equals to x, ganun. Naintindihan? Pag, ayan ay symmetric property. Transitive property of equality naman, if x is equals to y and y is equals to z, then x is equals to z. Ibig sabihin, no? Transitive property. No, if 10 is, if x is 10 and 10 is equal to z, then x is equals to z. No? Nalilito ba kayo? No, i-substitute nyo yun, mga value na yan, para, no, makuha mo. Sabi niya, if x is 10, at yung 10 ay z, so therefore yung z na yan at x ay parehas lang, equal lang din yung value niyan, no? To preserve the equation, always apply the same changes in each side of the equation. Yan. Kung anong ginawa mo sa left side, dapat ganun din sa right side. Yung sinasabi niya, to preserve the equation. For example, 10 is equals to 10. Kung ito ay nag-add ka ng 7 sa left side, dapat sa right side may add 7 ka din. Kapag ito ay nag-subtract ka ng 3 sa left side, dapat sa right side mag-subtract ka rin ng 3. Ganun yung sinasabi niya, nga dapat yung tandaan. Kapag daw ikaw nag-multiply ng 4 sa left side, dapat sa right side nag-multiply ka din ng 4. No, to preserve on the equation. Always, no, apply the same changes in each side. No, sa left side at sa right side. Ganun po yun. Alright, so let's have an example. Okay, class. So, let's have this practice exercise. Do this. No, I will give you time to answer. Step 1, solution to solving equation. So, this is our given. We'll have 4. Number 1, number 2, number 3, and number 4. No, post the video para masagutan nyo muna. Multi-step solution to solving equation. So, this is your given. Okay, 1, 2, 3. 3 givens. Okay, now let's solve. Let's answer. So, how will we do this? No, let's have an answer. So, this is D plus 9 equals 12. So, sabi niya, no, you need to solve for the value of D. So, anong gagawin? To transpose this positive 9 to the left. So, magdagdag ka dito ng negative 9 sa left side. No, kung ano daw ginawa sa left side, ganun din sa right side. So, mag-subtract ka din ng negative 9 dito. Yan, ganun yung sinasabi nun kanina, di ba? So, this will be 0. So, D, no, D na yan. Magiging 0 na yan, diba? O, 9 minus 9 is 0. Is equals to 12 minus 9. Alright, so this is 3. So, therefore, yung value ng D ay 3. No? I-check natin kung tama nga ba. O, let's check. No? Kung tama yung D is 3. So, kapag 3 daw yung D, 3, substitute mo yun doon. D yan, no? D, that is 3. 3 plus 9 is equals to 12. Oh. 9, 3 plus 9, that is 12, is equals to 12. So, therefore, this is true, no? This is a solution, yung 3 na yan. Naintindihan? Number 2, F minus 7 equals 13. So, negative 7. So, ang gagawin mo, mag-a-add ka dito ng positive 7 sa left side at sa right side, ganun din. Positive 7 din, no? Ang idadagdag, no? Ganun. Kung anong ginawa sa left side, ganun sa right side. So, this is F, no? Magiging 0 na to, 7. Negative 7 plus 7 is 0. Equals, okay, 13 plus 7, that is 20. Yan. So, therefore, yung value daw ng F na yan ay 20. So, if you check it, so, change mo yung F sa 20. So, this is yung F mo, 20 daw yun. Minus 7 is equals to 13. Oh, 20 minus 7, that is 13. 13 is equals to 13. Oh, therefore, 7, 20, there is our solution. Yan, ganun yun. Naintindihan? So, we have number 3, 27 is equals to 3R. Tingnan mo. 27 is equals to 3 times R. Ibig sabihin, nagmumultiply ka dito, no? Nang ang 3 sa R. So, para makancel out yan dyan, kapag nagmumultiply ka dito, you need to divide, no? Divide. Kasi sa right side, ganun din sa left side. So, 3 divided by 3 is 1. So, makakancel yan. 1 na yan. No, R times 1 or R. Yan, R na yan dyan. 27 divided by 3. Alright, so that is 9, no? So, therefore, yung value daw ng R na yan ay 9. So, let's check. So, sa original equation mo, 27 is equals to 3. Tapos, yung value ng R na nakusolve mo is 9, di ba? So, check mo kung tama ba yan. 27 is equals to 9 times 3. 27. So, therefore, this is true, no? Yung value ng R ay 9. Naintindihan? Let's solve number 4. So, this is 5 times x or 5x is equals to 20. So, you need to divide it both side by 5, no? Kung anong ginawa sa left side, ganun din sa right side. So, magiging 1 na yan. 5 divided by 5 is 1 or 1 times x, that is x. Is equals to 20 divided by 5. Alright, that is 4. Diba? So, let's check. So, 5, no? 5. Tapos, yung value ng x mo na nasolve is 4. I-substitute mo yan dyan. Is equals to 20. Oh, therefore, 20 is equals to 20. So, tama yung nakuha mong value that is a solution. Naintindihan? Alright, so do this. Alright, tapos na ba kayo dyan? So, let's check your answer. So, question number 1, we have 2n plus 8 is equals to 24. So, ang unang gagawin mo itong constant na 8, no? Positive 8 yan. So, magdagdag ka ng negative 8 both sides, no? Para ma-cancel out na yan dito sa left, mapunta na siya sa right side. So, this is 2n, no, is equals to 24 minus 8. So, this is 16. Tama. Now, 2n, no, naka 2n pa siya, dapat n lang yan dyan. So, therefore, mag-divide ka naman dito ng 2 at ganun din sa right side, no? Para magiging 2 divided by 2 is 1 or makakancel na yan. N is equals to 16 divided by 2, that is 8. Yan. So, pwede mo rin yan ma-check, no? I-substitute mo yan dyan. 2, tapos yung value ng N na nakuha mo is 8. Plus 8 is equals to 24. So, this is 2 times 8 is 16. Plus 8 is equals to 24. Yan. Therefore, 24 is equals to 24. Ayan. So, tama siya, no? So, therefore, correct yung value na nakuha mo, n is equals to 8. Naintindihan? So, dito naman, negative 2 siya. Negative 2. So, kailangan, no, mag-a-add ka naman ng positive 2, no? Kung anong kabaliktaran na sign niya yan, yan yung dinadagdag o ginagawa mo sa left at right side. Ha? Alright, so this is 5x, no? Makakancel na to. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0 is equals to 25. Yan. Tingnan mo, may kasama pang 5 yung x. So, mag-divide ka dito ng 5 sa left side at sa right side, no? Kung anong ginawa sa left, ganun din sa right. Cancel na yan. So, x is equals to 25 divided by 5 equals 5. Therefore, 5 yung x mo. So, let's check. No, 5, ang value ng x mo is 5, ito yon. So, i-substitute mo yung dyan sa value ng x, minus 2 is equals to 23, no? So, this is 5 times 5 is 25, minus 2 is equals to 23. So, therefore, 23 is equals to 23. Correct. Yan, naintindihan? So, ito naman, no, last number 3. 8x plus 1. So, pwede mo itong gawin, no? Ipagsama mo yung mga x at yung mga constant at yung may variable. So, this is 8x, no? Ito, ilipat mo siya. Kung ililipat to, di ba positive, no? Magiging, magsasubtract yan. So, negative 2x is equals to, copy the 7. At yung positive 1, mag-transfer siya sa right side. So, magiging negative yan dyan. Yan. So, 8x minus 2x, that is 6x, is equals to 6. So, therefore, dito, no, may x pa, may 6 pang kasama yung x mo. So, divide both side by 6. So, therefore, yung value ng x daw ay 1. So, let's check. 8, no, times value ng x mo is 1, plus 1 is equals to 2 times 1 plus 7. So, 8 times 1 is 8 plus 1, that is 9, is equals to 2 times 1 is 2 plus 7, that is 9. So, tama yung sagot mo. Alright? I hope you learned something. No, don't forget to share this video. Thank you and have a nice day. Goodbye.